Well, hello, Fairmont Falcons. It's Mrs. Walton from the library, and I'm here to read to you a book that I found in the library that kind of confuses me. I don't know if you've ever seen it before. I've never read it before. It's called The Book with No Pictures by B.J. Novak. I kind of thought that would be an easy one for me to read because if there's no pictures, I don't have to hold up the pictures because it's just going to be words inside. So I'm just going to read to you, and I don't have to show you any pictures, I guess. Let's see what this book is about. The Book with No Pictures. Doesn't sound very exciting. This is a book with no pictures. It might seem like no fun to have someone read you a book with no pictures. What do you think? It probably seems boring and serious, except here is how books work. Everything the words say, the person reading the book has to say. Of course. No matter what. Okay. That's the deal. That's the rule. So that means even if the words say lork, wait, what? That doesn't even mean anything. Blurf. Wait a second, what? This isn't the kind of book I wanted to read. And I have to say every word the book says? Uh-oh. I am a monkey who taught myself to read. Hey, I'm not a monkey. And now I'm reading you this book with my monkey mouth in my monkey voice. That's not true. I'm not a monkey. Yes, I am a monkey. Also, I am a robot monkey. What? And my head is made of blueberry pizza. Wait a second. Is this whole book a trick? Can I stop reading? Please? No? And now it's time for me to sing you my favorite song. A song? Do I really have to sing a glug, 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 my face is a bug. I eat ants for breakfast right off the rug. What? This book is ridiculous. Can I stop reading yet? No? There's more pages. I have to read the rest. My only friend in the whole wide world is a hippo named Boo Boo Butt. Boo Boo Butt. And also, the kid I'm reading this book to, or the kids I'm reading this book to, is the best kids ever in the history of the entire world. Oh, really? And these kids are the smartest kids, too, because these kids chose this book even though it had no pictures. I think I chose this book, didn't I? Because kids know this is the book that makes grown-ups have to say silly things. Okay. And make silly sounds like, oh no, here it comes. Glurp, go wonko, map, map, adieu, ay, broog, 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 eemf, blaggity, blaggity, glibbity, globbity, globbity, glibbity, beep, beep, eeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeee Oh my goodness. Please don't ever make me read this book again. It is so silly. In fact, it's completely and utterly preposterous. Next time, please, 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 please choose a book with pictures. I know I will. Please. Because this is just too ridiculous to read. The end. Bonk. I didn't want to say that. Well, that was my book tonight. I thought it would be really fun just to read a really, really, really silly book. Because I was in a really, really silly mood. Okay, Falcons. See you next week. Have a great weekend and happy reading. Bye-bye.